All right, everybody, it's Tuesday afternoon, August 3rd, 2010, and I've been running into a very, very common issue, so I want to go ahead and clear it up and explain to people, what paperwork do I need for MCCNV to be able to help me? All right, so here's the deal. It comes in steps. So if you've sent your packet away but haven't gotten a letter back, all you should have is like a wallet copy or your attending physician statement. So for MCCNV to be able to help you, if this is all you have so far is your attending physician statement, you need to have this. You need to have an ID, a valid ID, and a receipt that shows that you paid the postage to mail this in. I don't care if you have the receipt, the video, everything, whatever you need, have it. Have your receipt for your money order. In other words, I have everything that I need to show. That's the 51. See, I still have my receipt for my initial packet. So there's my initial packet, money order receipt. There's when I sent it in, which you'll notice down there for, it says right down there somewhere for 150. So I have my money order, my sheet that I went to the doctor, my receipt that I mailed it in, and my ID. This is the hardest part. When you're a new patient, this is it because you're in a gray area. If the state hasn't received an application from you yet, they don't know who you are. And technically speaking, you might have a medical necessity defense, but you are not legal in the sense that you think you are. Let that be known. The burden is still on you at this point in a court of law. So you have that method. Now, once you've mailed that in, the first thing that you receive back is a letter like this one. And people are coming in and it has your application with the state seal on it. Do not remove the letter from the paper with the state seal. This letter is the actual one that's from the state. This proves the state knows who you are, not this one. This is just a copy of something you already sent to the state that they stamped that says that they received it. This is actually verbiage that says we know who you are and here's what we're doing for you. So you need this top letter is more important than the bottom one. But this is the first letter. They send you a letter plus your application back. All right? So if you have this, then you'll need this. And once again, your ID to validate. The next way that we can help you is if you've already sent that in, you've already got your first letter, and now you have a second letter, the one where it says, hey, we thought about you. Go to the DMV and get your card. Boom. This way will require you to have a valid ID with it. And then the last way is to have the card, in which case you just need to have your card. So hopefully that clears up the paperwork needed for us to be able to help licensed patients with the things that we're able to discuss here in our shop. Okay? So make sure that if you're not sure whether you stand in the right places within the state of Nevada, call. The number is on the website. Google Nevada Medical Marijuana Program and call and leave a message and find out if the company that you paid or whoever it is that you've used to do this service, find out if they truly have done everything that they're supposed to do the correct way with the state. Because in order for us to help you, you will need to be in one of those stages of the process. All right? So hopefully that clears that up. A lot of people have been coming in that have just the attending physician statement. If all you have is the attending physician statement and nothing else with it, and the words fingerprint card and notaries mean nothing to you, then there's a strong chance that you need to get down here and speak with me so that we can find out whether or not you've been hit by a fly-by-night company. All right? But we wanted to put this video up to clarify exactly what it takes for myself and MCCNV to be able to offer our services to you if you're a licensed patient looking for certain things that we offer to licensed patients only. Now, if you're the general public looking for information, by all means, information is free all day long about the program. If you're coming in looking for information about how to start a business, so on and so forth, that information is posted on our fees and how to schedule 30-minute appointments or hour appointments to be consulted with, and our rates are posted as well. All right, everybody, I just wanted to put this video out there to give that clarification and a little late afternoon dosage. We shall see you again tomorrow. If you haven't been down to see us yet today, I'd get down here and see us if you're a licensed patient. If you're a licensed patient, instead of picking up the phone, I would pick up my wallet, I would put my card or whatever I just showed you in the video that you might need depending on what step you're at in the process, and I would come down here and ask to speak with us about what we might be able to help a licensed patient with. All right, everybody, this was Tuesday afternoon, August 3rd, 2010. I gotta go prep for 420, which is coming up here in about 50 minutes. So I hope everybody's having a great Tuesday, and we'll see you again tomorrow.